Hello again, my friend. My name is Amy D. McKnight, and we are still in Module 1, The Basics. And in this video, we are looking at the basics of how to start. And this is the Epically Creative Rigid Heddle Weaving course. All right, in this lesson, you will learn how to load your shuttles and how to start and finish your weaving. Let's look at how to load your stitch shuttle. When loading your stitch shuttle, the simplest thing to do is just think figure eights. What do I mean by that? Well, we're going to do a figure eight when we put our thread on the end to keep it there, to hold it there to start. This is especially helpful if your shuttle does not have a little notch in the end that some shuttles have that make it a little bit easier to put the thread in when you're beginning to wind the shuttle. And you're also going to think figure eight when you're putting the shuttle on the edge. So instead of going around and around and around and around, we're going to do like a figure eight. That actually makes the thread build up on the edge so that it's not this great big belly in the middle that makes it harder to pass through the shed. We don't want to overload our shuttles, because if it's too thick, if there's too much yarn on your shuttle, then again, it makes it harder to pass through the shed and it makes things snag. And we want to have a fun time weaving. We don't want to have, we don't have to force it through the shed. So you don't want to overload your shuttle. Next up, whip stitch start. So we're going to learn a hem stitch later on in another lesson, but for now, I'm going to tell you about whip stitching. Whip stitching will hold the stitches in place so that you can tie, twist, or braid the ends of your weaving. So feel free to hem stitch if you know how to hem stitch. Whip stitching, I'm sharing this now, and I'm sharing this for those new weavers, because I'll be honest, when I was first learning, like, when I first got started and I first started learning about hem stitching, I couldn't get it right. I would take so much time trying to get it right, and I would get confused, and it would just like mess me up, and I would feel like kind of frustrated because of the fact that my hem stitching just was not looking the way that I wanted to, and sometimes I get kind of irritated with that. So whip stitching works. And it ensures that your weaving does not come undone before you can secure the ends. So if you're a new person starting out, you will learn to hem stitch. You will learn to get better at hem stitching with practice. But until then, I give you permission to whip stitch the beginnings and the ends to secure your weaving. All right, y'all. So in this lesson, you learned how to load your shuttle, how to start your weaving. I want you to go ahead and take action now. Follow along with me as I wind my shuttles, spread my warp, and whip stitch the beginning of my projects. Those are going to be some videos that will be following this one. So after this video, you should see some more videos that will help you to be able to visualize that part of the process. In the next lesson, you're going to learn how to achieve consistent salvages, how to play with the beat, and how to add yarn and or change colors. Now, go ahead and get the game board. If you haven't already, get the game board, download it, print it out. It's the Basics of Weaving game board, and it's going to help you follow along with what I am sharing in this module and in these lessons. And if you're not in my community, which I'm about to tell you about in a minute, you can still share your progress on social media. Use the hashtag Creative Weaving Basics when you share, so that we can all see what you're doing, and tag me, and I will go ahead and give you a heart to encourage you as you are doing this, because you know what? It's like really cool to be doing this together and to see what other people are doing. Now, if you want to go deeper, if you want to be able to show me what you're doing and others, and have us comment on it in a way that you can get some more encouragement and support, If you want to maybe go a little bit deeper and join me on my weekly Zoom calls and get even more support in that way, then I have a weaving community and you can join it by visiting myweavingcommunity.com/join, and there you'll see the different membership levels that you can join the community and get some extra support. But hey, if you just want to, if you more like to do things on your own, that's fine too. That's why these videos are here, so that you don't have to feel like you have to join the community in order to get access to the information. Kind of doing things inside out. Alrighty, y'all. Please like this video if it's been helpful to you. If you want to encourage me in what I'm doing, like the video. Leave me a comment below. Let me know if you learned something new. Please subscribe to the channel and turn the notification bell on. I've got a lot of videos. I have modules. I have 6 modules that over the next coming weeks I'm going to be putting out. So if you don't want to miss it when I put out these videos, and there's some real gems coming up, go ahead and ring the bell so you'll be able to know exactly when I put them out. And please share this video. There's somebody out there that's probably wanted some help, wanted some understanding of how to do some of these things you may take for granted. And so share this video, and it helps others and it helps this channel. Alrighty, y'all. Thank you so much for watching, and I can't wait to see you in the next video.